Hey everyone, welcome to another video. I'm super excited for this video because I'm going to show you guys what we are doing for kindergarten and second grade homeschool for the 2020-2021 school year.
You look so beautiful, and I'm so lucky to be yours. And you're taking me high.
Alright, I'm just going to jump right in here and get started with the family subjects that we are doing. If any questions pop up throughout the course of this video, pause it and comment them down below and I will make sure to answer them for you. If you want to see flip-throughs of any of this stuff or get more detail about any of these curriculum pieces, then also let me know that and I'd be happy to do that as well. The first family subject that I'm going to show you guys is our science. And we've been using The Good and the Beautiful for science the past two, I guess this is our technical second year of homeschooling. We didn't really do formal homeschooling for Bailey's kindergarten year. We did bits and pieces of stuff, but this is our second full-on formal year of homeschooling. And we are doing the arthropods unit from The Good and the Beautiful. It's still in the plastic. I have not had a chance to prep it yet. But basically, I just get a binder and print out a label for the unit. I also print out a label to put on our science wall, so I've done that, and then I prep the unit accordingly. So we're excited to do this unit. The girls picked it. I wanted them to kind of have some input on which unit that we were going to do. And then depending on how fast we go through this one, we might do another unit after this, but we will be revisiting botany in the spring of next year because they loved it so much. I loved it. They learned a lot, and just the repetition is not going to be a bad thing. So we are going to be doing this one in botany for sure. And then we might have one more if we get through this one quickly that we do in between those. The next family subject is history. And this, if you watched my last curriculum video last year, we did not have a history curriculum. I was basically kind of piecing things together myself and it was okay, but it just was a lot of work. I wanted something chronological that started from prehistory and went all the way until now, and I just wasn't finding that really. But then I stumbled upon History Quest. So this is amazing. We've actually already done 4 units of this, and so we're just gonna kind of pick back up where we left off. But it is History Quest. It has this giant reader, but the stories in it are so fun and engaging for the girls. And then we put together a little binder, my early times history notebook, so they each colored a page that I put in there. And then I did buy the study guide as well. So I highly recommend that if you do this curriculum, you do get the study guide because this lays everything out for you. It literally does all of the work other than gathering any supplies you need. So it has been amazing. It has all of the printouts in the back that you need, pictures to go along with the units and things like that. And then it also has the schedule for each unit and what to do each day. There's discover, explore, create, demonstrate, and enrich. So those are the themes of each of the days. This has been so fun. And like I said, we've already done a few units in it. One of their favorites was when we studied the Stone Age and did prehistoric cave paintings. So this was Quinn's, I believe. And Bailey did a handprint. So they did like cave paintings. So we just are kind of keeping everything here in this binder. And then I also purchased the Big History Timeline sticker book. So the timeline is up on our wall, but these are the stickers that go with it. And as we learn about something, we just take the sticker off and put it up on the wall. So we kind of have a visual of what we've learned about and how much fun stuff there still is to learn about. The next family subject is geography. And this will look familiar if you watched our curriculum video last year, because it is Around the World with Picture Books Part 1 by Beautiful Feet Books. And the reason is because we kind of really slowed down with geography last year. I was pregnant from October to June, so we just kind of did the important like reading, writing, and math things. We did a few of these units, so we're about probably a quarter of the way through, maybe a third of the way through this book. And I wasn't really like stressing about too much about doing this. They were first grade and preschool at the time. We also have their composition books, so they basically kind of color pictures, and we write in facts that they learn about each location. So that was China, and we just do it that way. We do it very informally and make it fun. We read stories, lots of books, which is why I love this curriculum, because it's very book-based. You read a lot of picture books, which has been tough with the libraries being closed, but our local library just reopened for curbside pickup, so I'm really excited about that, and that should make this a lot easier to get back into. You can buy the whole set of books that go with it, but it was just too expensive for our taste, and we can get them for free from the library, but I'm excited to jump back into that for geography. The next family subject is art, and again, this probably looks familiar from last time. I had this last time, I showed it to you guys that it was going to be our art curriculum, but we had just received it in the mail and hadn't done any of the projects yet. It's called Home Art Studio. We got the kindergarten level just because it's the first level they had. That way we can work our way up. And we have gone about halfway through, I think there's 18 projects, so we've done half of them, and they are amazing. The teacher teaches everything on the screen. I'm an artistic person. I can recreate art pretty well, but I'm not very creative when it comes to thinking up the ideas myself and describing them. I don't know the terms and all of that kind of stuff, and she teaches it for me, which I love. So we have been really liking this and are going to continue with the second half of this, which, because we kind of have been loving it so much, I think we might get through it a little faster than we did the first half, especially now that I'm not pregnant anymore and struggling. But if we do, we'll just go to the first grade version, because we're definitely going to stick with this. And then for social studies / U.S. government, we decided to purchase the Tuttle Twins books. And the ads have been all over Facebook, so I'm sure many of you have seen them. Some YouTube families talk about them too, but we got all 11 books, and they teach about free market and the government and the role of government. It's, you would think that reading it from a liberal perspective, which I have, I would not enjoy these, but I do actually really enjoy them, and it has actually made me think a lot about things. I've read through about half of them because I wanted to read through them before we do them together. And it brings up a lot of interesting topics and points, and I really love it's just no nonsense, like, factual approach in a story way. So we have the PDF versions of the workbook, and I'm probably going to print just one set out for Bailey, and then just make copies of the pages that Quinn would want to do, the coloring pages and things like that, because there are some pages that is just too much for a kindergartner to even want to attempt. So that's going to be how we go about that, but I'm excited to get into these with the girls and teach them about government. All right, and then possibly the most exciting family subject that we have is our Spanish curriculum. This was another one last year that I did not have a curriculum for. We just kind of were introducing it with, like, fun games and songs and watching, like, YouTube videos, singing the alphabet, and just kind of simple things like that. But I really wanted to get something a little more involved, but I did not want a workbook-based curriculum. I wanted something that would be fun for the girls, that they wouldn't even feel like they're learning, that would be hands-on, just because they are a lot younger. And I stumbled upon this Spanish subscription box called Hola Amigo, and it also, I'm pretty sure, came from a Facebook ad, so they're probably listening to me. I'm sure they are, but it has been amazing. So we got our first box 3 days ago, and we actually did the first kind of lesson today, and I do that in air quotes because there's not, like, a set order to do it all in. It's just kind of all in the box. It gives you guidance on all of the activities and fun stuff like that, but it doesn't say, like, do this first and then do this and then do this. So we chose to read a couple of the little books. We made fun games out of it. There's flashcards in there that we use. They created a little boat, which I actually have here. They each made a foam sailboat, because they are learning about the summer, the beach, and a sailboat was one of the terms that they learned. So that was a lot of fun. It was a fun family project to do after we had dinner before the girls got ready for bed. So I am definitely going to do a I guess you wouldn't call it flip through, but like I'm going to show you this curriculum and show you what's inside it because I think it'd be amazing for elementary age kids to learn Spanish and do it in a fun way that's not just sitting down writing in another workbook. All right, those are all of the family subjects we have and the ones that we'll be doing together, whether it's just the girls and I or at night or weekends when Anthony's here. We'll try to be doing science, Spanish, and sometimes art when Anthony's home because it's fun to have him involved in the process too. Especially with art, it's nice to have his help. So those we try to do when he is home, but the rest of them we do with us three. Real quickly before we get into their individual ones, I also have this book that I just got, Home Learning Year by Year. And it literally is what it is. You go year by year, you turn to the grade that your kid is in, and it basically tells you everything you need to know in every single subject for that grade. And I can kind of like make sure we're on track using this. Also kind of to make sure we're on track, I have what your kindergartner needs to know and what your second grader needs to know. So I actually found this one at a consignment sale for $1. I was really, really excited about that. But these go through, and I've already got the kindergarten one tabbed because I got it first. It goes through just like that other one, and year by year, or subject by subject, tells what each of them need to know for their grade level so I can make sure that they are learning what they need to learn, which I'm pretty confident they are. I'm pretty sure we're ahead in a lot of areas because with homeschooling, doing it one-on-one, you can go a lot more in-depth, which is one of the big benefits of it, but that just kind of helps me like have a guide to make sure that's happening. All right, and now for individual subjects, I'm going to start with Quinn, who is almost 5 years old and is in going into what would be kindergarten. I guess technically she would be too young for kindergarten by like a month. I think she'd miss the cutoff. So she would technically be in preschool again and waiting to go into kindergarten if she was in the public school system, but she's definitely at kindergarten level. So she's a kindergartner for our purposes. But the first thing that she is doing that's her own individual subject is music. These are Bailey's old workbooks because Quinn has not started year two yet. I think they're supposed to start at the end of this month, and so she hasn't gotten her books yet. But she does, so does Bailey, but she does the Let's Play Music 3-year course program, whatever you want to call it, and it's with a local teacher in her home with a small group of kids, and it is called Let's Play Music. This is the second year. She has yellow arrows and green turtle shells, so she'll be a green turtle shell first the first semester and then a yellow arrow the second semester. Last year was blue bugs and red balloons, and she just basically was introduced to the concepts of music, getting her body moving to the rhythms, and it was very play-based and fun. This year is also still play-based and fun, but she does get to start on the keyboard, which is super exciting. And then for math and reading, she's using the readingeggs.com website, and it has a math program as well called Math Seeds. A lot of people use this as kind of like an addition to a different core curriculum, but I have found that it's actually a really amazing curriculum on its own, especially since they came out with workbooks that go along with the subjects and the levels that they do online. So I'm sure many of you have heard of ABC Mouse if you've not heard of Reading Eggs, but I kind of think it's similar to that, but we like Reading Eggs a lot better. It's very, very, very well thought out, especially the workbook portion that goes with it. And she is over halfway through this kindergarten level book already, actually, because she started last year. So she's going to get through this and start the first grade level one at some point this year. But again, it's going to be the same kind of workbook and the online game. So we basically do the online game the one day, and then the next 2 days she works on the workbook pages that go along with it. There's 4 workbook pages total per online lesson. And then for reading, I mentioned she's doing readingeggs.com, and that's the same kind of workbook, just the reading one. And she is about almost exactly halfway through this one. So again, she'll be moving to the first grade reading book at some point this year, depending on how quickly we get through this one. But we do the same kind of thing, online one day, and then 2 days of workbooks. And I stagger it to make sure she's not doing both online math and reading in one day. That way she gets to do something online each day and isn't like overloaded with workbook pages, because we definitely don't want that. But in addition to her Reading Eggs curriculum, we have been working through this 100 Teacher Child to Read in 100 Easy Lessons. You saw this on my last curriculum video if you watched that one, and we are on lesson 63 out of 100. We kind of like take this a little slowly. We have worked on it throughout the year. And she has done great on it. We've picked it back up the last couple of days and she's still loving it and doing great. I find that as long as I do this when she's not tired or hungry, she loves it, has fun with it. We kind of turn it into a game sometimes. And I really want to instill the love of learning in her. I really didn't have to try with Bailey because she just already loves learning. She's like me. She just loves school, workbooks, anything she can get along those lines. But with Quinn, she definitely needs to have more game-based and play-based things and less structure. So that's kind of the avenue that I'm taking with her, and taking workbooks a little bit slower and not pushing them on her if she doesn't want to do them each day. So that is it for Quinn's subject. She's just doing reading and math. She gets her handwriting practice in her workbooks. It's kind of built in, especially to the reading one. So that is also covered in there. But for Bailey, she is doing Let's Play Music Bridge. So Let's Play Music is a 3-year program, and she just completed year 3 this past year. So she composed her own song on the keyboard and performed it in her virtual recital and did such a great job, and we're so proud of her. But there is a bridge class that she can take with the same teacher who she loves, and she is really sad that this will be her last year, but that will bridge the gap basically between Let's Play Music and like formal piano lessons. So these are her workbooks for that. They're songbooks and workbooks, flashcards, all that fun stuff. So she is really excited to start that soon, within the next month or so here. And for math and reading, Bailey is doing the same curriculum that Quinn is, Math Seeds and Reading Eggs at readingeggs.com. So she has her level 2 math book, which she's almost halfway through, so she's working through that one. And then for reading, she completed the whole Reading Eggs map course last year, like I think it was this summer, so in the last like school year, and was so proud of herself. And so she got to move on to Reading Express, which is for older kids. I think it's 7 to 13 or 7 to 12 year old, 7 to 13 sounds right. And she took a placement test at the beginning and it bumped her all the way to fourth grade level. So I knew she was gonna pass the first grade level and possibly even the second grade, but I did not think she was gonna be going to the fourth grade level. So she has been working on that. She's just started, she's just done a few lessons of it, but she's doing the online and then workbook portion of the fourth grade reading. And then also kind of in the same language arts spectrum is grammar. She, rewind a little bit, spelling. She does spelling on the Reading Eggs website as well. So that's an all online thing that she works on. And then there's spelling pages in this reading workbook as well that she does there. So now fast forward to grammar. She did Growing with Grammar level 1 over the past school year. She has a few lessons left in that and then she's done. So we will be starting Growing with Grammar level 2. And it comes with the book, the answer key, and then the tests and test answer keys as well. And there are not very many tests. It's very spread. I think there's like 8 tests total for the whole entire workbook. It's a very no-nonsense, no-frills curriculum. But it's very quick, and she loves the fact that it's quick. She basically, it's one page front and back per lesson, and she completes it in 5 minutes, sometimes 10 if there's a lot of writing, but it's very fast. So she really did not like grammar at first because she wasn't really a fan of writing, but now she's getting a lot more confident with her handwriting, so she loves grammar. It's like the first thing she wants to do. And then new this year that we are introducing for Bailey is a handwriting curriculum. So before, when she was doing reading eggs, I mentioned Quinn's handwriting kind of also takes place in that workbook, and Bailey's did as well. But with the Reading Express curriculum, they focus really not at all on handwriting. It's mainly grammar, spelling, comprehension, things like that. So she needed a handwriting curriculum. And she knows how to write all of her letters, but she definitely could use work on them. And I want to start teaching her cursive maybe the second half of this year or the first half of next year. So I wanted to kind of get her with smooth writing strokes and writing it in a way, I can't remember what it's called, there's a name for it, but writing it in a way where it's going to be easy for her to transition into cursive, if that makes sense. I researched a few different curriculum choices, and The Good and the Beautiful was one of them. I can't remember the other one, but I ended up setting on the Getty Dubé handwriting series, and I really love it because it's a Getty Dubé italic. So she is starting on book B. Book A was a little too basic for her, so I'm starting her on book B, which is kind of basic, but I think she's going to actually benefit from that. And it shows how to do the pen strokes in a way that will make it easy for her to transition to cursive. So she'll go for an A, she'll go around, up, and down. So when she does cursive, around, up, down, and she can continue without picking up the pencil. I think before she was writing her A's, or currently she's writing her A's, like she goes down with the line and then she does the C, or she does the curved part of the A first and then goes back up to do the line. So this will just help her make more kind of cursive-like strokes for her handwriting, and it's always good to practice your handwriting anyways, so that'll be nice for her. So that is all of the subjects that we are doing this year for kindergarten and second grade homeschool. And I did get this planner this year, the Happy Planner. Before I was just using a basic, I think it was a dollar store one. So I got this year, and I will also be posting a video showing you guys kind of how I plan all of this stuff with this. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you click subscribe if you're not already. And if you click the little bell icon next to the subscribe button, it'll just send you a notification when I post a video. That way you can go watch it and not miss it, because sometimes YouTube doesn't notify you or show you when the people you're subscribed to post new videos. So definitely go do that. If you're still here and you've watched to the end of this video, post this emoji down in the comments below so I can thank you directly for supporting us and for watching our videos in full, because it really, really helps us out. But for now, remember to stay humble, be kind, and we will see you next time.